Dear friends, let us look at the important aspect, that is the character of Julius Caesar in the play Julius Caesar. When the play opens and the action develops in the play, in the very first act, we come across the idea of the conquests of Julius Caesar. When we look at the character of Caesar, we have to consider his conquests. Julius Caesar, even though had not been crowned as supreme king of Rome, had conducted many conquests and succeeded in defeating some kings, especially the defeat of Pompey and his sons is a remarkable aspect of the part of conquest of Caesar. It doesn't mean that Caesar is supreme and powerful and extraordinary character in his physical aspect. Caesar was emotionally and mentally strong, but physically quite weak. The aspect of his weakness is also significant. Cassius gives two examples of the weakness of the character of Caesar. One is when Caesar invited Cassius to take the challenge and accept the challenge of swimming the Tiber River. Cassius accepts the challenge, but Caesar, who was overconfident, was defeated in his effort to swim the very overflowing Tiber River. Caesar fails to cross the river and reach the another part of river. He could not succeed in swimming. It was Cassius who saves Caesar. Physically, Caesar was not strong as Cassius or Brutus is one thing. Another weakness of Caesar is Caesar suffered from epilepsy or fitness. When he was in Spain, Caesar experienced fitness and fell unconscious. Like a weak girl, Caesar helplessly cried for the help. That shows how Caesar was very weak. Physical weakness are limitations of Caesar. This is another side of Caesar. But apart from this, Caesar was very kind and humanitarian, and there was such a consideration in his life. Caesar was not harsh, not cruel. He considered kindness and gentlemanliness as important character of his life. Brutus and Cassius think that Caesar was ambitious, but Mark Antony refuses to accept the allegation on Caesar as ambitious. After the murder of Caesar, in the forum scene, when Mark Antony makes his speech, he disproves the allegation of Caesar growing ambitious. He tells that Caesar was the kindest human being and there was that genuine sympathy in Caesar. And Cassius, after the murder of Caesar, at one stage admits that Caesar was gentle and humane, and he admits that he failed to understand the real character of Caesar. Such a gentle man is very rare to be born. That is what tells how Cassius also understands his mistaken understanding of the character of Julius Caesar. Cassius feels sad, and there is a sense of remorse in Cassius and even in Brutus. How they fail to judge the character of Julius Caesar is very significant when there is a sense of remorsefulness in Cassius and Brutus. Brutus is very humble in admitting the character of Caesar, that he misunderstood Julius Caesar, and that led to believing the words of Cassius and ultimately making a conspirators group and developing a conspiracy against Caesar that led to the murder of Caesar. And even when Caesar makes a last remark, when he was stabbed by Brutus, that you too, brute, or et tu, brute, that is understood very late by Brutus. And Brutus, before he participates in the Sardis war, realizes that. And before his death, Brutus makes a comment that you have not deserved death, such a gentleman you were. These remarks are very significant and they add to the height of the intensity of tragedy in the life of Brutus, or the mistaken identity of the character of Julius Caesar. Another thing that is very significant is a general estimation and a statement that is made regarding the character of Julius Caesar. It is said that Caesar dead is more powerful than Caesar alive. In terms of physical presence and in terms of presence in the absence of Julius Caesar, it is very true. Caesar physically and during his living time comes on the stage in a very, say, little moment. That is, his presence is very short during his lifetime in the play Julius Caesar. He comes in the Lupercal festival procession, and afterwards only when he has to go to the Senate hall. As he was entering the Senate hall, he was murdered. These are the two important occasions that we see the presence of Caesar. But after his murder, it is Brutus and Cassius who could not be relieved from the presence of Caesar and the psychological impact of Caesar. The whole play that becomes so significant after the murder of Caesar is in the form of the memory and the significant character of Caesar. So, living Caesar appears for a short period, but dead Caesar appears for a long time in the play. How Shakespeare makes the character of Caesar present even though he was not present on the geographical, physical world of this Rome or the history of Rome. This is where we consider the tribute paid by Antony as a significant one. How Caesar was kind and the very injustice that is done by Brutus and Cassius as unkindest thing in the world. The character of Caesar that reflects his service to Rome and the greatness of Julius Caesar in the history of Roman Empire is seen throughout the play in one or the other way, either in the speech of Antony or in the remarks of Brutus that he was half not deserved to be killed, tells us and makes us understand how Caesar is occupied everywhere in the living characters after his death. Thank you.